This video covers three springtime sessions at another mark in Shoreham. This time I'm at Shingle Road, which is a bit west of the Burrells. I'm here with the intention to try and catch plaice, but quite often you've got to adapt to conditions. If the plaice aren't showing, then there's other species to be caught. Conditions during the first session of late April seemed ideal for plaice.
Bright sunshine, clear water and wind from behind.
I'm using my familiar setup with reels carrying 20 pound braid. My Comic 07s can punch out the distance required for the plaice. My favoured rigs are three hook clip down versions and boom rigs. Short wired boom rigs can get extra distance compared with long wired ones. With shorter hook lengths and smaller hooks, these quite often outscore the three hook clip down rigs, but generally the fish do tend to be smaller.
Although the wind for me is in the right direction, it is a little bit breezy and there is some wind noise on this video.
As I'm preparing to cast out my second rig, I'll run through the locational details. Previous videos have covered the regional setting, so here I'm just starting with the Shoreham and Lancing area. Many may recognise some of the more familiar marks, with Widewater, the Church of Good Shepherd and the Burrows being within Shoreham. Shoreham Harbour is also a popular area to fish. At the Church of Good Shepherd, you've got rock armour groins, but the beaches towards the east are open. Here I've located the Shingle Road stretch and then I'm zooming in on the area. These are the access points onto the beach. There's limited parking along Old Fort Road and Shingle Road itself. I fished the same spot for the three sessions in this video. I've arrived at the top of the tide and there isn't much of a tide to pull, hence the need to tighten up to my leads. Sometimes it helps to leave your line slack if you're fishing for a flat fish, but I prefer to tighten up and have a bend in my rod tips. My rigs have been out for half an hour and I hadn't had a bite yet, which is a bit disappointing. After replacing one of the worms on my boom rig, I then start moving my gear down the beach as it's ebbing now. I won't wind in my free hook clip down rig. I'll just take up the slack as I'm moving my rod down the beach. Still no bites, so I wind in the clip down rig and get it ready for recasting. All time passes without any indications and a further move down the beach is required. Normally expect to catch within half an hour to an hour and a half down the tide, but that's not been the case today. Although I'm contemplating packing up and going home, it quite often pays to stay until at least halfway down the tide, if not right to the bottom. It's always worth staying until there's a slight change in the tidal pool. You can get a spell of activity from the flatfish, either as it starts pulling more or if it slackens off. If there's a lack of activity like today, then dragging your baits more often can help. Here I get a bite, immediately after tightening up to my rig. I strike and I'm glad to say that I connected with a fish. Well, that's my only bite of the day, but I'm pleased to say that it was a place. Not that big, but at least its target achieved. All in all, a pretty disappointing day, but I'll be back soon to try again. A week or so later I was back, but I was a bit concerned that conditions were a bit too rough for place. A strong onshore breeze and coloured water didn't look promising. The waves were a bit larger than before, but I wasn't going to let that put me off. I'll still have a go to try and catch flatfish, but I've also got bass in mind. Therefore, it's still a little bit too early in the year, these conditions seemed ideal for bass. The waves were causing my rod tips to bounce about quite a bit, and there's a fair amount of spray in the air. Same gear as before, but this time I'm starting with 2 3-hook clip down rigs. Last time I only had rag one with me, but this time I've got both lug and rag. I started off casting at distance for both rods, but I am considering fishing closer in. My first bite came after I decided to cast my rig close in. It was a sharp pull round, definitely not a place. Well, that's a good start. A fairly decent scaldy bass.
My second bite came at range, but this time just a little knocks.
And it's a flatfish. I'm both pleased and surprised to say that it is a place.
My next bite came back to that rod, fished fairly close in, just about 15 yards out.
It's another flatfish, but this time, as you'd expect, so close in, it's a flounder. Now trying both rods fairly close in. bit more salt spray now, and unfortunately that's affecting the video quality. I had what I thought was a fairly decent fish on, but unfortunately it came off in the surf. Didn't take long for the next bite. Unfortunately, I struck that too soon and didn't connect. I think I got a proper hook hold this time. My second place. It wasn't caught close in, but it also wasn't at full range. Another little bite close in, Results in flounder number 2. Despite the rough conditions, there's still no need for leads with wires, and as you can see, I'm using pyramid leads here. Casting close in, there's no need to clip down, but I'm back at trying at distance again. Fished on until the light started to fade, and finished off with this dogfish. Despite the poor conditions, I'm fairly pleased with this result. I wasn't at all expecting those plays. The change of tactics to fish close in also paid off. Bass and flounders like the surf conditions, so they're always an option if it's too rough just to fish for plays. Next time I came, I was greeted with windy conditions once again, so fishing close in will also come into play.
To begin with, both rods have been cast at distance. Having cast out the second rod, I need to check to make sure the lines haven't crossed. The tidal pull seems stronger this time, and there's a nice bend in the tips. As you can see, I'm using the same rigs as before, both with pyramid leads, clipping down for distance but leaving it unclipped for closer in. This cast is 20 to 30 yards or so, but we'll try much closer. That one's gone about 60 yards, but we'll try it a lot further out if I can get it that far. Although it's fairly close to the top of tide, it's still coming in, and the wash from the waves is getting too close to my gear, so I need to move up the beach a bit. Whilst moving my gear, I did spot an indication on a rod fished at distance. I noticed another little tap, so it's worth striking. Once again, the picture quality is being affected by the salt spray, so apologies for that. I wasn't able to clean the camera lens as often as I would have liked for this session. So my first bite produced a nice scaly bass at distance. The bass was on the top hook, so it fell for ragworm. I've got both ragworm and lugworm again this time. Now I decide to fish my inside line a lot closer in. Another bite at range. The good knock this time came from a small smooth hound. Next bite was from close in. Smaller than the one that was caught at distance, but still put up a scrap in the surf. Another reasonable schoolie caught at range. About 3/4 an hour into the ebb now, and I'm still getting bites. Well, that's more like it. I wasn't sure whether the flatfish would turn up at all. And I'm pleased to say that it's a double shot. It's one reasonable sized place and a smaller one. And yet another scaly bass. And that's a slightly better one to finish off on. All in all, a most enjoyable session with 7 bass, 2 plaice and that smooth hound. So, even though the conditions weren't right for plaice, a few still turned up. However, they're not much of a size. Apparently though, so far this year that seems to be the norm on the Sussex coast.